Sarah Champion for Absolute Radio. We are joined by Caleb and Matt, who play, who headline, of course, British Summertime Festival this evening. Are you happy to be here in Hyde Park?
Oh, yeah. We love it here.
We've been looking forward to this for a long time, so we're very excited to be here.
The last time we saw you was at the secret gig that you played for Absolute Radio, which was just incredible. It was the week that Walls was released. Mm-hmm. I think Nathan tweeted that it was one of the greatest nights of his life. Was it about that gig that just, it was electric. Was it for you? It certainly was for us.
Yeah, it was pretty special for us. I mean, we don't get that many opportunities to play smaller venues and kind of, and also, you know, to play to our fans where we can play a lot of old stuff without them getting bored. So, yeah, it was just a lot of fun to be able to kind of remind us of the old days, I think.
Well, actually, we asked some of your fans to tweet questions for you guys, which I'll get to. But one of the main questions was, are they going to play any more secret gigs? Will there be any more small secret gigs? A knowing smile.
I'm sure there will be. We've been so busy on the scheduled bigger shows at the moment, but it's good to know that people want us in those smaller venues. We'll try and hit them if we can.
How do they compare for you? Because obviously when you can see like the whites of people's eyes compared with, you know, crowds of thousands.
They were pretty bloodshot, actually.
That's all they might be.
it can be kind of nerve-wracking, you know. I feel like it's easier for us at this stage in our career to play for a big crowd, even though I can still see everything. I have this weird vision. I can see who's enjoying it and who isn't, even if it's way far out. But it's definitely, you know, it's more so when they're just right there in front of you. But yeah, like I said, you know, the fans tend to be pretty good in those moments, so we've been fortunate.
It's a two-way thing though, isn't it? Kind of feeding off the energy of the crowd. So when they're that close and you can see them and you can see how excited they are, that must give you a buzz too.
Oh yeah, definitely. Yeah, we did that two times, right? One in New York and one in London. And they were just amazing experiences. So we want to do it again.
This gig is a pretty special one. I was here on Friday for, the lineup was Mike and the Mechanics, Blondie and Phil Collins. And Phil Collins had his 16-year-old son do one of the most famous drum solos of all time. Blondie was, Debbie Harry was celebrating her 72nd birthday that weekend. Do you see you guys still playing into your 70s?
Right now, no.
Just a bit tired.
But who knows? I mean, you never know. I think you'll probably get the itch to continue playing. But I don't know. I mean, 70, 72, that's pretty old. Wow. And I feel like we're kind of tough on our bodies. I don't know if we'll be moving around that well at 72.
I feel like we've come so far now that we just be, I don't feel like we could stop. So maybe 70, maybe we could do it.
Album 45.
at least. Listen, a lot's happened since you started out, both, you know, professionally, personally, your family men now. How does life on the road now compare with when you just started out? I mean, I've seen, you know, this trailer that says family. I'm guessing things are a little bit different these days.
Yeah, I think it's better. I feel much more comfortable on the road. I mean, I've been here at Hyde Park all day with the family. I've been at parks and stuff, and we've been running around, so it's just, yeah, you just got a kind of that home feeling, but you're out on the road, you know? That's great. I prefer it to the early days, for sure.
Are you going to watch the Pixies before you guys go on?
Yeah, definitely. They've inspired us so much since the beginning of our career, so it's pretty surreal that, I mean, it's surreal that we're even, you know, playing on the same stage as them, but let alone to be able to watch them before we play is, it's terrifying. I'm going to throw up on the stage as they're playing and then run to my dressing room and cry for a little bit and hopefully gain some composure and get out there and do it.
So we did ask your fans, because I know, you know, the UK fans are pretty special to you guys. We were sort of here from the beginning. M. Ward wants to know the best concert you've been to that's not your own.
Wow. That's tough. I mean, I feel
like our concerts are just so good, it's hard to
I set the bar pretty damn high.
I went and watched Arcade Fire last night, and it was pretty incredible.
Yeah.
In some, like, boxing ring or whatever. But, I mean, we also have shared the stage with some pretty amazing bands. So technically we weren't playing, but a lot of those Strokes gigs early on, the U2 gigs, Pearl Jam, seeing Bob Dylan was pretty amazing. I don't know. I mean, we also live in Nashville, Tennessee, which is Music City. So there's a concert pretty much, every week you can go see something pretty special.
Coach Buey on Twitter, what flavor bubble gum does Nathan usually chew? Any ideas? I don't know where that's come from.
It's a really gross one.
It's vodka, I believe.
Vodka, yeah, red wine. I don't know what it's. It's not traditional bubble gum. It's like this grape, weird grape flavor that he prefers. It's a ton of it's full of aspartame.
Jasmine, what's your proudest moment as a band?
This right here, this
really?
Interview.
This interview, this is the highlight of your
career. We just peaked.
Career. It's all downhill from here. Kings of Leon fan blog said in an interview, you plan to play smaller venues, you said. Is that going to happen? I guess we sort of touched upon that. You'd like it to happen.
KOL fan blog said that?
Yes.
Oh, nice. play smaller venues. I mean, yeah, well, they pretty much just point us to the stage and we go play. But yeah, we would love to play smaller venues by choice. Hopefully it's not a thing that we can no longer play big venues. But yeah, we would love to. We feel like we really get to stretch out and do weird stuff. We just did 3 nights in a row in Dublin. And that was such a great experience because we got to mix up our set list every night and, and play songs that we haven't played before. And so, yeah, I mean, we really do at this point in our career, we love to play concerts. So, I mean, I am tired right now, but we do enjoy it.
Priya says, if you were to release a cover version, what would it be?
A cover? I don't know. We always kick around ideas. We have some Thin Lizzy songs that we would love to cover.
Which ones?
Oh man, Cowboy Song is one.
Renegade
would be amazing. I don't know. There's just so many.
Yeah. The thing is with the Thin Lizzy songs is we always tend to, when we do covers that we've done in the past, we tend to just do them exactly how they are, and I don't know if I can play guitar that well yet.
Bill, that's it. Danko, if you could collaborate with any British band, who would it be?
I have no idea.
Yeah, I don't.
I'm really out of the loop. Are we talking about living bands right now, obviously?
Do you know what? He didn't specify, so let's say that it doesn't have to be living.
The Clash would be pretty awesome.
I don't know.
I want to name someone funny, but I don't really know anyone.
They're all good. The ones I can think of. I mean, any of them. Yeah.
Spice Girls.
That's a collaboration I would pay money to see. Neri says, what's your favorite thing about London?
The people, man. It's just it's our kind of place. Everyone seems to enjoy a good time. It's funny. Every time we go to a concert, we see people hanging outside of a pub, and we're just like, my God, we're on our way to work, and they're getting drunk already.
If it's 11 a.m., they're drinking.
Yeah.
Oh, it's miserable.
Yeah. No, we just love the people here. And they've always been so good to us. And at this point, we're seasoned pros. We have all our favorite spots. So, yeah.
Well, listen, thank you so much for speaking to us. I know you're excited to see the Pixies. We're excited to see the Pixies. We're excited to see you guys as well. Enjoy the gig. Thanks so much.
Thank you.